I grew up in the age of Timberland and Pharrell. I grew up in the age of Timberland and Pharrell. Yeah. I grew up in the age of Timberland
and Pharrell. Hello, I'm Philip, and I'm going to show you how to do the degrees on the units. That is how you do degrees on the unit circle.
Hey guys, it's Megan, and this is the unit circle with the degrees, and the explanation is going to be next. This is the explanation for degrees on the unit circle, and as you can see, this is an example for the first quadrant, and when you add the degrees together or subtract them, you get spaces in between, and it will always apply for each quadrants for your degrees.
The formula for finding degrees with radians is pi times 180 over pi, which equals degrees. An example is 3 pi over 2 times 180 over pi. The pi's cancel out and you're left with this, 3 times 180 over 2. Then multiply 3 times 180 and then divide by 2 and you end up with your answer.
Hi, I'm Nina and I'm going to show you a trick to remember the angles with your hand. Your pinky, the straight line is 0. Then you have 30, 45, 60, and 90. Next on your hand, you have the radians. 0 goes with 0, 30 degrees has pi over 6, 45 degrees has pi over 4, 60 pi over 3, and 90 pi over 2. And the formula for all of it is square root over 2. Hey, it's Nina again, and I'm here with
Annalisa.
And we're gonna show you how to get the outside of the circle. So I'm going to take my hand like this, and I'm going to start with a 0, and I'm going to put my finger in, and that's going to give me 0, 1 comma 0 with the 4 and the 2, and then I'll do the 30, I'm going to do the same thing with this finger, and then the same thing with... And then you're just going to continue to do it with each finger, plugging it into the formula on pi, square root over 2, all the way. And then with the 90 to get 0 comma 1.
Hi, I'm Asher, and we're going to go over the quadrants, okay? So, this is quadrant 1, this is quadrant 2, this is quadrant 3, and this is quadrant 4. You're welcome. Hey guys, it's Asher back with another one, okay? So what you do here is you have the degrees and then you times them by pi over 180 and then you simplify and then you do that with all the degrees and that's how you get the radians on the unit circle.
Hey, it's Annalisa and I'm back here with
Joseph and we're going to teach you how to get these points. So you take these exact same points and you flip them and you use the negatives like you would with the quadrants.
Hi, I'm Dennis. Once you get the radians, you transfer to the unit circle.
Alright, so to start things off, I'm going to do a simple example from top to bottom. Let's take pi over 4. So in this case, you're basically going to substitute pi for 1. You're going to add 1 plus 4, the line directly across from it. 1 plus 4 equals 5. You keep the denominator, 4, you get 5 pi over 4. Now, I'm going to do it reverse. So, let's take 7 pi over 4. What you're going to do in this case, since you're going from the bottom to the top, you're going to subtract. So you're going to take 7 minus 4, you will get 3 pi, you keep the denominator. And there it is.
This is the design of the unit circle. We use this to memorize it.
Four still alive!